Hi, good evening. Thank you very much for taking the question. Would you like to give a kind of your evaluation of the game tonight, please?
A very difficult game against a very good team. First half, we had lots of possession, but they counter-attacked really well. Transition attacked quickly and created some big moments in the game. And thankfully, we had the best goalkeeper in the world tonight. David was fantastic. And very happy with his performance. Second half, they had more of the ball. It was still open and they deserved to lead. But, you know, Old Trafford is magic. Champions League, Old Trafford. Sometimes that history can would helped us. And tonight, Cristiano, of course, came up with a good goal and Alex scored a fantastic goal.
Bueno, un partido dificilísimo contra un gran rival. Sabíamos esto antes del partido. Villarreal abrió muy bien el partido. Nosotros también habíamos tenido una buena posesión de la pelota y bien en las transiciones, pero luego ellos dominaron más la pelota y tuvieron unos grandes momentos y grandes ocasiones. Y gracias en este momento actualmente el mejor portero del mundo, David De Gea, nos salvó un poco en cuatro ocasiones. En la segunda parte fue un partido también abierto. Ellos han marcado primero con el liderato, con el gol de Alcácer, pero luego era como la historia de siempre en Old Trafford. Estamos acostumbrados de marcar muy, muy tarde y Cristiano llegó a marcar el gol victoria. Claro, el gol de empate muy bueno también de Gea, pero un gran partido entre dos grandes equipos.
¿Xavi y Mata?
Hola.
Hiya.
Hi.
Javi.
Sí, mister.
Yeah.
Hola, ¿qué tal? Yo quería preguntarle, usted tiene una experiencia larga como jugador y ahora dentro del fútbol. Se ha enfrentado dos veces al Villarreal. Si tuviera que decir una virtud de este equipo, algo que lo ha hecho sufrir, ¿qué diría? ¿Cómo lo valora el Villarreal? ¿Qué tipo de equipo y a qué nivel lo compararía?
Gaffer, you've actually had great experience in the game, both as a manager, coach and a player. You've now played against Villarreal as manager twice. If you were to pick out one virtue, one point that stands out, a real positive about that team, that hurts you, that's hurt you on a couple of occasions, and made life difficult for you, what would that point be? What would that virtue or quality be?
Oh, that's not easy to give just one, because there's many. Very, very good team. But they come here with the belief and the trust and the confidence to play football, technical football, passes on the floor, and the goal they scored, for example, was played straight through us. Very, very good patterns of play. So, a very well-coached team.
Yo creo que es difícil solo nombrar una sola virtud, porque hay muchas. Son muchas las virtudes. Yo creo que hemos visto un equipo que han dado cara en Old Trafford esta noche. Han venido aquí creyendo en ellos mismos, con confianza, y han jugado muy, muy bien. Es muy buen equipo el Villarreal. Y han comenzado muy bien el partido, jugó un fútbol muy técnico en el suelo, y el gol nos cortaron por el medio en nuestras líneas. Era un muy buen gol. Entonces, sí, solo elogios para ellos.
Hi Ollie, congratulations on the win. Sorry, a bit of feedback. What can you say about the character of the team and just how important it was to win in such circumstances after the disappointment of recent home games and a game in Burnley itself?
We gave ourselves a difficult job, of course, with the sending off last game against Young Boys. And to get the 3 points at home is important. We know we need to get to 10, maybe 12 points to go through. So, massive result for the team and, of course, for the spirit of the team as well. It was it's a better way of winning the game than the way we lost the game last week or a couple of weeks ago. So that's football. It's just highs and lows. And today we get a result that we're delighted about.
La pregunta era cómo se puede expresar los apuros que habéis tenido en el primer, en la jornada, primera jornada frente a Young Boys, en comparación con ahora, habéis respondido muy bien después de la primera derrota. Bueno, sí, nos ha hecho la vida muy complicada a nosotros con la expulsión en Suiza, pero ahora, después de cosechar esta victoria de hoy, somos capaces de cosechar 10 o casi 12 puntos para tal vez asegurar el paso a la próxima ronda. Pero el fútbol es así, es lleno de altibajos. Nunca se sabe lo que va a pasar, pero yo puedo asegurar que es mejor ganar en el último momento hoy, como hemos hecho, que perder en la manera que habíamos perdido en Suiza.
Hi Ole.
Hi Samuel.
David had possibly his lowest moment for the club in the final against Villarreal. Since then, he's possibly been your best player. How pleased have you been with his form, and just how would you? How's he been just overcoming that setback back in May?
You're probably right that he had a difficult summer after that. Of course, he went to Euros, didn't play there, but he's really come back with a determination and a belief and a work rate that I've enjoyed. And today he got his, again, he got deserved outcome, because he saved us tonight. We have to be realistic and say that without David, of course, we've got two very good keepers with Tom and Dean as well, but today David deserves, for me, man of the match.
Bueno, ¿cómo se puede hablar de la remontada de David De Gea después de su peor momento de la carrera, tal vez de la final en Gdansk y luego en el verano? ¿Cómo ha respondido? Bueno, yo creo que sí, era un momento difícil la final para él, y luego se fue al Euro y no figuró ni un momento, ni un minuto. Entonces, su actitud, sus ganas, su ilusión, el hecho de que cree en él mismo, ha respondido muy bien en la pretemporada. Y yo creo que hoy debemos mucho a David. Nos salvó, hay que decirlo, no se puede negar. Y sin David no hubiéramos ganado hoy. Y yo creo que merece la figura del partido de hoy.
Okay, last question from Phil Thomas.
You need to unmute, Phil.
Sorry,
here we go.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now? his standards, he didn't have a lot of the ball tonight, didn't get many chances, was a pretty quiet sort of evening compared to what he's done in the past. Does that just say what great players can do? They need one chance and they suddenly become the headline act with a last minute winner like that. What Cristiano brings to this team, to wherever he goes, really.
Yeah, he's done that so many times. And, you know, when you saw him against Ireland a couple of weeks ago or a month ago, he missed a penalty early, didn't touch the ball more or less, and he scored two great headers in the last 2 minutes. That's just what he's done throughout his career. He's so strong mentally. He just stays in the game. I've seen him all day today, the way he's built himself up for this game, how focused he's been. And when he gets that one chance, it's a goal. He had a couple of half-decent headers first half that could have ended up with chances, but a true mark of a very, very good finisher, that he keeps calm when the chance arrives.